Hello students, and welcome in today's discussion. Today we are going to discuss unit 6, reproduction. Now this session is very important because in this session we are going to discuss all chapters of unit 6 from the exam point of view. Here I am going to say you each and every chapters, every point, how it is important for exam. Which types of questions will be asked. So whenever you will prepare every chapter for the exam, just see this video and it will be make you very easy your study. So these are the small capsules for your better study. So let's start our today's session, Unit 6, Reproduction. Now this full unit carries 14 marks. In this unit, total 4 chapters are there. In that, chapter 1 is Reproduction in Organism. Now in that, first point is reproduction. So here definition of reproduction will be asked and importance of reproduction will be asked. What is the importance of reproduction? 2 marks question will be asked. Definition for 1 mark it will be asked. So very easy and simple way of reproductions, definitions and importance you have to prepare, just this much in this point. Next point is that a characteristic feature of all organisms for continuation of species. So what are the characteristics every organism has developed? Maybe it is a microorganism, plants or animals. This you have to study, how they adapt for more and more production of their species to remain alive on the earth. Next point is mode of reproduction. So based on this question will be asked types of reproduction. Give the 2 types of reproduction or which are the different types of reproduction. So here 2 major types are there, sexual reproduction and asexual reproduction. This you are going to study in detail in this. Asexual reproduction in microorganisms you will study, in case of plants also you will study. And some of the lower animals are there. And there also we can see a asexual reproduction. And sexual reproduction, it will be seen in a higher organisms, complex organism. So seen in plants as well as in animals. One more most important part is that tissue culture technique, whatever we are studying in this chapter, is comes under asexual reproduction. So keep this in mind. Asexual reproduction and its various ways are there, that based on that types will be asked or examples will be asked or picture will be given that you have to identify the type of reproduction. So various types of questions will be asked on this point. So this point is very important from the exam point of view. Based on this point, 2 marks question or 1 mark question will be asked. Next point is asexual reproduction by binary fission, sporulation, budding, gemmule formation, fragmentation, vestige propagation in plants. So these are the various ways given of asexual reproduction. Again, it is very important which part of the plant is used for which type of reproduction. So the type of reproduction and part of the plant and example of the plant will be asked here. Then type of asexual reproduction like binary fission, sporulation, budding and the example of this type of reproduction will be asked. So it will be asked a type or it will be asked an example or will be asked a both. So again for 2 marks or 3 marks question will be asked on this last point. So this first chapter is important for 1 mark or 2 mark question. Majority 1 and 2 marks question will be asked from chapter 1. Now go to the next chapter. Chapter number 2. Your chapter number 2 is sexual reproduction in flowering plants. Again very important chapter. Right. So in this first point is the flower structure. So general structure of the flower we are studying in this point. So what are the different parts of the flower? Start from the stalk till the pistil, right? So stalk will be there, then thalamus is there, then calyx is there, corolla is there, stamen is there and pistil is there. So all different terminologies will come in this point. So structure of flower, again the question will be asked for drawing diagram of LS of a flower. So typical structure of LS of flower will be asked to draw. So diagram is again important here, and description, different parts of the flower will be asked. Next point is that development of male and female gametophyte. Now in case of a plant, because this full chapter is based on flowering plants, right? So in that, development of male and female gametophyte means development of stamen and development of pistil you are studying, right? So this full development, how the pollen grain is developed in anther lobe that you are studying. In this point, the development process, the structure of pollen grain, diagram of pollen grain and LS of anther lobe, again very important. 3 marks question will be asked on the diagram of the pollen grain, then LS of the anther, how the pollen grain development is takes place, that diagram will be also asked. Again, outer very hard structure of the pollen exine is there, that is made up of sporopollenin, that question will be also asked. So this point is again very important. Next, female gametophyte, that is ovule development, right? So in the that ovule development, the diagram of the ovule is again important, and the development of the ovule, how that 7-celled 8-nucleated structure is formed, female gametophyte embryo sac is developed, that is again very important. So 3 marks question will be asked on embryo sac development. Next point is pollination types, agencies and example. So here pollination types will be asked. Till today we have learned the self pollination and cross pollination, right? But here some of the different terminologies are used. So that new terms along with the types of the pollination, 3 types are there: xenogamy, jejunogamy and autogamy. So these are different types of the pollinations we are studying here. Then the agencies, agents which help to carry out the pollination, insects, wind and water. And which are the different types of the plants are there? They have adapted for these 3 different agencies. So they are different adaptations also we are studying with the help of their example. So this is very very important. Based on this point you have practical also. So this point is important theoretically as well as practically, right? Then next, outbreeding devices. You know that cross pollination is very very important. So how this cross pollination will be favored and self-pollination will be avoided. So this will be developed by outbreeding devices. So what are these outbreeding devices which favors the cross-pollination? These are actually 4 outbreeding devices. So based on these 5 marks question or 3 marks question will be asked. So make IMP for outbreeding devices point. Very important. Even this point is again very important. Adaptations of the pollination. Next, pollen pistil interaction. Whatever the reactions takes place once the pollen grain is land on the pistil, then what changes takes place in that? How both pollen's reaction and pistil's reaction to the pollen is given? That is given here in a pollen pistil interaction. Whenever the received pollen grain is right, then what changes takes place? And when the received pollen grain is wrong type, then what happens? This we are studying in this point. So sometimes question will be asked in pollen pistil interaction. Just go through the 3 points are there. Then double fertilization. Again, very very important point is there. Most of the time question will be asked on what is double fertilization and how it is takes. So double fertilization is that again very important, which mainly occurs in angiospermic plants only. So in this, The fertilization takes place at two different places and two different types. One is syngamy and triple fusion. So just remember these two words, that is syngamy and triple fusion. So what are their products? So that will give you a double fertilization idea. Based on this, diagram is also there. So you have to prepare diagram. Once you prepare a diagram, you can easily explain the double fertilization process, right? So definition is need to be prepared very well and the diagram. So your these 3 marks question will be covered up. Next is that post-fertilization events. Post-fertilization events means that what happens after the fertilization. Actually, pre-fertilization event is also there, fertilization is there, and post-fertilization is there. Pre-fertilization, in that development of gametes will be there, formation of the gametes will be there. Then their fertilization, where the fusion of male and female gametes will be there, and zygote formation. And once the zygote is formed, all rest developments will be there, that will be considered into the post-fertilization event. So in this post-fertilization events, development of endosperm is there, embryo is there. Then from this endosperm, by utilizing this endosperm, how the seed is formed and how fruit is formed, all these developmental processes are there, that will become in the post-fertilization event. So in that, some of the new terms are there: endospermic seed, non-endospermic seed, or ex-albuminous seeds and albuminous seeds are there. Then perisperm means what? This is one more new term is there. So based on that, 1 marks short questions will be asked. Give difference, one difference for 1 mark it will be asked, or 2 marks questions will be asked. So this post-fertilization developmental process is there, that is quite important. Next is that special modes, that is apomixis, parthenocarpy and polyembryony. These 3 terms are there. Many times the questions asked on these 3 terms, that is apomixis means what? It will be asked. What is important, where it is applicable. Then what is mean by parthenocarpy? And what is a polyembryony? In which type of fruits we can see the polyembryony? How it is useful? So these all points are there. These 3 terms will be asked for 3 marks, either for the definition or write a note or explain, anything will be asked. But these 3 points are again important, may be asked for 1 mark or 3 mark. Last point is that significance of seed dispersal and fruit formation. How the seeds get dispersed from one place to another with the help of wind, water or animal, that we are going to discuss here. And for that dispersal, how the seeds are get adapted, that we are seeing in this point. So based on that also the question will be asked, maybe 2 marks. And fruit formation, how the ovary, you know that the ovary is further developed into a fruit. So how this ovary develop into a fruit? Ovary wall is there, how it develop into a fruit wall? Then how the different layers of the fruit walls are there? Their different pictures are also given. So all these points are again important. And in picture, the different layers of the walls are given, that is epicarp is there, mesocarp is there, and endocarp is there, that all together forms the pericarp. So based on that, diagram based question means picture will be given and the labeling you have to identify, ABC will be there, or the definitions will be asked, or the examples will be asked. So from exam point of view, this chapter is very important. Majorly 2 marks or 3 marks questions will be asked from this chapter. Next, our chapter is chapter number 3, human reproduction. Very important chapter, because if the 5 marks questions need to be asked from this unit, then it will be asked either on the chapter number 2 or chapter number 3. Rarely it will be asked on chapter number 4 also, but majoritarily more focus is given on chapter number 3. So chapter number 3 is very important. Now in this full human reproduction we are studying. So first point is male and female reproductive system. So in that we are going to study the male reproductive system, its various parts and diagram. So if you do a diagram with a label, then no need to describe or mug up the description of that diagram, right? If you know to draw a diagram, you can easily write a description. So prepare well diagram along with the label. Same there for the female reproductive system. Nicely you prepare female reproductive system's diagram along with the label, because based on the diagram and the functions of the parts will be asked for 5 marks or 3 marks. So very important point, diagram, labels and functions of every organ in the reproductive system, that you should know, right? So this is the important point. Our next point is that anatomy of a testes and ovaries. In the anatomy we are going to study the internal structure of the testes. So whenever we take a TS of a testes, how the internal structure looks, what is the outermost layer is there, then where the sperm mother cells are there, how they divide, how the sperm is formed, Sertoli cells are there, interstitial cells are there, what is their function, all these points we are studying in the anatomy of the testes, right? So this point is very important. Here again the diagram of the TS of testes will be asked for 3 marks. So if you will see the enlarged view of this diagram, then there are total 6 labelings are there. So that's why the diagram and the labels togetherly it will be asked for 3 marks. The next is that the anatomy of the ovary. Again ovary's diagram is given, and how these egg primordias are there, primary follicle, secondary, tertiary follicle, Graafian follicle is there, corpus luteum is there. All these labels you should know. How the secondary follicle develops into the tertiary follicle or Graafian follicle. How the ovulation takes place. This you should know. So diagram is again most important. And what is the function of the corpus luteum? That you need to be remembered. So anatomy of the testes and ovaries is again very important. Will be asked for 5 marks or 3 marks. Next is that gametogenesis. In the gametogenesis, spermatogenesis and oogenesis. These are the two very important processes are there. How the sperm is formed, that is spermatogenesis, and how the egg is formed, ovum is formed, that is called as the oogenesis. So once this point is over, at last both comparative diagram is given. So that diagram you have to prepare very well. Only that diagram will be asked for 5 marks. So this diagram is there, exact location of the primary follicle, then secondary follicle. That location is there where the meiotic cell division takes place, or in case of oogenesis, where the first polar body is formed, where the second polar body is formed. That you need to be shown very clearly, right? So this diagram is very very important. Do well, and I will give you guarantee that 5 marks question will be asked on this. Suppose this diagram is not asked and related to the spermatogenesis or oogenesis, any question will be asked, that may be of 1 mark, 2 mark, 3 marks or 5 marks, you are able to write the answer, right? So this point is very important. Nicely you have to. Next point is menstrual cycle, which is again very important event which we see in female, right? So on this point most of the time 3 marks question will be asked. Now that question will be asked diagram based. So whatever the diagram is there, that you have to prepare very nicely. If you see the diagram, then in that hormonal changes within the 28th days cycle is there. So in first 5 days, then up to 14 days, then on 14th day and next up to the 28 days. what changes takes place day wise or phase wise, right? So that all of LH hormone, FSH hormone is there. Then how the ovule is developed within these 28 days, 4 phases. Then how the changes takes place in endometrium, wall of the uterus. These all things are there. Then level of estrogen and progesterone hormones is there. How it is changed. So these 4 points are there. And that based on these 4 points, together diagram is given. If you prepare a diagram with better understanding, then any twisted question will be asked on this, then you are able to write an answer, right? So prepare this diagram very nicely, and if this diagram is again very important, based on the diagram question will be asked, based on the phase question will be asked, or based on the hormones question will be asked, right? So prepare this diagram in menstrual cycle nicely. Next point is fertilization. How this fertilization takes place, male, female. How this fertilization takes place, that event is given. What changes takes place when the sperm penetrate the outer layer of the ovule. That is very important, that changes takes place in the ovum. So that need to be studied. 2 marks question will be asked on this point. Next point is embryo development up to blastocyst formation. Now, again, here diagram is given. So that diagram you need to understand. All the stages of these zygote development up to the blastocyst is given as A, B, C, D. And their location is also given in the female reproductive system. Right? So that location and the number of cells along with their name you have to remember. So based on that, sometimes question will be asked. That will be asked 2 marks or 3 marks, or rarely 1 mark question will be also asked. But if you prepare this diagram, you can give any question's answer based on this diagram, right? So prepare diagram very well, not very difficult. Then next question is that implantation. So what is mean by implantation and how it is takes place? Once the embryo is implanted in the endometrium, then what further changes takes place, how the placenta is formed, that is given in detail. So that paragraph which is given in the textbook is very important, prepare that one. Then placenta formation up to the pasturation is given. So in that, based on the placenta, how it is formed and what is the function of the placenta, most of the time question asked on this point, right? So the process of formation of placenta and the functions of the placenta, prepare it very nicely. 2 marks, 3 marks question will be asked on this. The next is that the pregnancy and parturition. So what is the gestation period is there? Once the baby is fully developed, how the parturition process is takes place, then how it is initiated, start the process of parturition, that is given in reflex section, right? So that again you need to prepare. Sometimes the question asked on this initiation of the parturition process, that is the reflex section. Fully matured baby start this process, and based on that 3 marks question will be asked. So you need to prepare that process very very well. And the last step is that the lactation. Now in the lactation, how the changes takes place in the mammary gland, how the milk glands produce the milk, the number of the lobes in the mammary gland, diagram is given, right? So see that diagram, see the number of lobes. So that small things are there, just you focus on that, and small questions of 1 mark will be asked from such locations where when we study we think that okay, let it be, no need to be focused more, but the 1 mark question will be asked from that place only. So whenever you will read the chapter, each and every line is important, each and every point is important. So prepare well, and more focus should be given on the diagram. So diagrams are the most important in the biology, and in the unit 6, this is the chapter which is very important. because most of the 3 marks and 5 mark question will be asked from the chapter 3. Now let's see our next chapter, chapter number 4, that is reproductive health. Now in this chapter we are studying what is the reproductive health. All we know about the health, but what is actual the definition of the reproductive health? So definition is very important. 1 mark question will be asked on the definition. Then next, need for reproductive health and prevention of sexually transmitted diseases, right? So here the need for reproductive health and prevention of sexually transmitted diseases are given. So why we need to take care of our reproductive health? That is, need to be prepared. So 3-4 points are there that you have to prepare. 2 marks question will be asked for need of reproductive health. Then based on that, again the government has initiated so many programs related to the reproductive health. So that program's name will be asked. What is the another name for this program? Or RCH is given, right? So that, what is the long form of RCH? That will be asked. So short, 1 marks or 2 marks question will be asked on this first point. Then birth control need and method. So what are the different methods to control the birth or the pregnancy? So these all methods are known as the contraceptive method. So various contraceptive methods we are learning in this point. So in that 5-6 contraceptive methods are there. So based on that, IUDs are very important, oral pills are there, then implants are there. These are some of the points based on which questions will be asked in the exam. Among these all, which is the method which will prevent the STDs? That question will be asked. Then IUD is there. In that, types of IUDs will be asked and examples of the IUDs will be asked. So among these all methods, IUD is most important. Even the implants are there. On that, what are the combinations are used, or implant contains what? That will be asked. So prepare with this point of view, prepare this point. Next is that medical termination of the pregnancy, that is MTP. 3 marks question will be asked on the MTP. When it will be carried out, when it is safe, when it is unsafe, when it is legally allowed, when it is illegal, that all. Amniocentesis, one more term is there. Based on that also, so many times question asked. How it is carried out, when it is carried out, how it is misused. Most asked question is that how the amniocentesis is misused. So you need to focus on this point again. And last point is that various assisted reproductive technologies are there. ART, assisted reproductive technology, ART, right? So in that, various technologies are given which will assist to have a child for infertile couples. So based on this point, possibilities there, the 5 marks question will be asked. Otherwise 3 marks question will be there, 2 marks or sometimes 1 mark question. So among this whole 4 marks chapter, important points are there, amniocentesis, then IUDs are there, and this last point, ART, is there. These 3 points are mostly asked in an exam. So focus on these 3 points more, right? And if you will focus on these main points, then definitely out of 14 marks, means this full unit carries 14 marks weightage. So out of 14 marks, I definitely assure you that you will not score less than 10 marks, right? 10 or up to 14 marks also you can easily score. Just focus on the points which I have given, and based on that prepare well. All the best.